The cells of our body undergo constant change. Some part of the cell is destroyed, thrown apart, and some other parts are rebuilt. Sort of constant flux. This destruction part, removal of the damaged part, that is done by a process called autophagy or self-eating. Autophagy provides energy like heat for the regular function of the cell and also gives raw materials. Just like during remodeling of a house, we use components of the demolished part like bricks to rebuild new parts of the house. It took someone several years of hard work to unravel the mysteries and the control and regulation of this process of destruction stepwise and how it is accomplished. This is a real story. I love fairy tales, especially those involving the lovely princesses like Snow White or Cinderella. The story today is not about any princesses, but it is a Japanese boy whose name is Yoshimuri Ohsumi. It is not a name of a Pokemon. He was a real boy. Yoshimuri Ohsumi was a poor boy, sickly. His mother was bedridden for several years in a hospital with tuberculosis, was a lonely, deprived child. He found solace in nature, in his high school chemistry club, and also in starlit skies. This little poor boy grew up to be the recipient of Nobel Prize in Medicine or Physiology last year, that is 2016, for discovering or unraveling the mysteries involved in this autophagy or self-eating of the cell. How did this ordinary looking Japanese larva turn out to be a magnificent butterfly just by asking simple questions and by keen observation? When he started college, he started working on yeast. Yeast belongs to a family of fungus, the same family where our nutritious and delicious mushrooms belong to. Already, by the time Yoshimuri was in high school, it was already known plant cells have large vacuoles, sort of areas where nothing happens, areas of emptiness or nothingness, but area of nothingness filling almost 90% of the plant cell. Is it not amazing? However, these vacuoles are not just the private property of plant cells. All living cells had vacuoles. One of the initial realization by Yoshimuri was that vacuoles are not lazy nothingness. There's a whole lot of active processes happening inside the vacuole. They have a membrane cover, and inside that membrane cover, they keep the internal environment very much regulated. They have ions, they have acidity, they have amino acids, all sorts of processes. The membrane covering the vacuole was very smart too. They meticulously controlled what all things come in and what all things go out. One question Yoshimuri used to ask his students was, how many red blood cells are formed in every second? The answer is 3 million. Also, he used to ask, how many hemoglobin molecules are generated every second? It was 10 to the power of 15. That means a 1 followed by 15 zeros of hemoglobin molecules are synthesized every second. An average human usually consumes about 70 grams of protein. And the main component of the protein, nitrogen, is eliminated to the equivalent amount as the urea or other components. However, every day we are using about 240 grams of protein. Where does the balance come from? As mentioned, when you remodel your house, you utilize the components like bricks or other equipment or furniture of the old demolished part and put it in a, maybe varnish it, paint it, and put it in a new place. Same thing is happening in our body. The old damaged proteins are degraded to amino acids, the bricks, which is used to build new proteins. Even membrane components are digested. Even mitochondria is digested once it is damaged, and the components are used for rebuilding. The part that is not reusable is used for generating energy. Just like we use the old parts of the house, we burn it to make heat and light. Same way. It was around the middle of last century that was found that some vacuoles with the name lysosomes degrade proteins. Later it was found not just the proteins, also mitochondria and other components like membranes are also degraded as mentioned. It is this constant rebuilding that gives the cells the brand new look at any time. Yoshinori with his small team started working on yeast. Was it not Thomas Edison who once said that success is 99% perspiration and 1% inspiration? Yoshinori sweated a lot and worked very hard. In genetics, we always look for mutations. Mutations are spelling mistakes of genetics or genetic transfer of information. After screening 5,000 specimens, one of his graduate students detected one mutation. Soon, about 20 proteins were isolated. Not just with this one mutation, more mutations were discovered later. These 20 proteins work just like in a symphony, in perfect harmony. Proteins involved in autophagy are well regulated and controlled. They are called ATG, ATG1, ATG2, up to 20. But this field of research is still going on very actively. What Yoshinori did was opening a small window to a mysterious chamber of secrets. And the secrets are being unraveled and released for us. And that process is going on. If you like this video, subscribe to it, share it, and tell your friends. Thank you.